Hi, I'm Oscar van Deventer, and this is Number Escape. Number Escape is based on an idea by Jacques Griffioen. Jacques Griffioen had the idea of a rolling dice that has all the six numbers. So when you look at the dice from this direction, you see the number one. If you look at the opposite direction, you see the number four. Here we see the number two. From that side we see the number 5. Then from this side, and this is sort of hard to see, this is supposed to be the number 3. And from that side, and that's even harder to see, we are supposed to see the number 6. Or maybe it's the other way around. So Jacques liked this piece and he had the idea of number escape. So this piece is hidden in a block. And the object is to get it out. Maybe a little bit like the children's game, where you just have the triangle, the square, the circle. They go into the holes and the child should solve that. So this is supposed to be a more advanced version. So what we have here is a cage. And we see the number one here. Or I forgot, is it the number four? No, it's the number four. So we're looking for the number four. So this is the way that it goes in, and it can't go in any other way because it doesn't fit. So we put it in, and then the idea is that at the inside, because of the long pins, that it's not possible to rotate the piece in place. But you see, it can be rotated a bit and it's pretty flimsy. And the idea was that when you have it in some state, you can park the piece in one direction. So I'm parking it here by pushing them onto the pins. And now it's onto the pins. And the whole cage is a sort of twisty puzzle. So I can make this type of turn. So now I have reoriented the piece. And I can put it in here, and now I can, for instance, go down, make the same rotation, and after some rotations, the object is to get it out. So, for instance, get it out at the number 5, which is here, or at the number 2, which is there, or at, the 3 or the 6, etc. So in theory, you would have a lot of challenges. You go to from 1 to 2, from 2 to 3, 3 to 4, etc. I consider this a failed design. As you already saw, it's quite awkward to operate, to get with your fingers in between, especially if you're a child, you don't have this reach. Also, the piece in the middle is not well confined. If I use a little bit of force, I can reorient it. The long pins are flexible, they're a bit awkward, and perhaps worst of all, the twisty puzzle part. As you can see, it has some blockers, so the blue is blocking the orange, but when it can rotate, it's a very flimsy mechanism. It doesn't have the corner pieces, it has edges pieces that are very flimsy, so if you're not careful, you just derail the piece and things start falling out. So it's a nice prototype, it's a nice idea, but it's a failed prototype. And maybe you can help us here. Do you see any way to rescue this idea by Jacques Griffioen, the idea of a block with these shapes in three directions? Is there a way that we can turn this in a nice puzzle? Do you see that, or can we better abandon it? Thank you for watching.